My, what on earth happened to this frequency? Now, when I came out here earlier today, I had everything in fine order. And then as you survey around you, you can see that things have pretty much fallen to the wayside.
We got a whistle out here, Dan.
I like that wayside thing. What is wayside, anyway? I come in here to make a presentation for a good amateur radio frequency, doing all the right things. By the way, K9RSY at 40 after. Doing all the proper, fine business operation stuff that you need to do, and then you have big, fat pigs like K1LEM, little child molesters like N2FUV, gay boys like the NAMBLA CEO AC1DD, and K1LEM, the school teacher that sucks off little boys in the cloakroom, come in here and try to mess up my perfect frequency.
Damn right, man. I'll tell you, it's a travesty.
You left out K1 Fag.
It is. It's a travesty. Then we got K1FAG out there with his colostomy bag. I wish he'd hurry up and die of MS because I'm sick of hearing him, to be frank with you.
Yeah, I concur, doctor.
How's your liver, Danny?
I need somebody to go to the grocery store for me.
Well, why don't you hire Gary Davis? Be careful, though. He might eat all the
time. Yeah, maybe, Gary, don't go down and get you a tube of duck butter you can suck. That might clear up some of the MS.
I want a good-looking young boy to do it.
Well, that would be me. Come on over, big boy. I got just what you want right here. I'll stick this in your 130-pound ass, and you won't ever come back for more. Trust me. I'll have you so full that crap's going to be coming out your mouth.
You're nasty.
Do you really think so? You think maybe somewhere along the line I might have crossed the line?
Your wife must be ashamed of you.
No, she's not. Which one? I've got four.
That's a good answer.
Or your most current one.
That's a hell of an answer.
Let's see, the first one, she's semi-ashamed. The second one, yeah, she's probably pretty ashamed. The third one, she don't like me at all. The fourth one, she said to say, hey, give it to that little K1FAG. Just pack it in his ass and his little muscular dystrophy or multiple sclerosis. What is that thing you got wrapped around you that you crap in? What is that, colostomy bag? Just give that little faggot hell. I said, okay, darling, anything you say.
Oh, boy.
Four tries, but when you got to the fourth one, you finally found a woman on the same page.
I did. You know, it was a long journey, but I did finally prosper at the end.
Yeah, you know.
More alcohol does.
We were on a journey, and I'm told you can't get to your end. There's a few obstacles along the way, but you.
That's what alcohol does to you.
That's right. And the guy talking about alcohol out there, do you have a call sign? No, you don't.
I'm also dying of AIDS.
It don't matter how many times you gotta try, as long as you keep trying. You finally found one that you were yoked with, and boy, there you go.
Yeah, bless the Lord. Matter of fact, she's going out the door right now. God bless you, hon. I'll stay in here and take care of K1 Fag and K1 Licks Every Man and AC1 Double Dildo and Hair Lip Haney that just can't get enough of my butt. I'll take care of it. You drive careful, sweetie.
Oh, boy.
who was the guy in there had a comment about me but didn't have a call sign? I want a little bit of your ass. Where are you at there, tough guy?
I want your liver.
Where's the guy out there that felt all brave and stuff where he thought, well, I'll just talk in my mic and be a big guy? Do you have a call sign behind that, or are you just really a pussy like Joe and Gary and Mike and Haney? Do you belong in the pussy crowd, or are you in the men's crowd?
Hey,
let's make a declaration right now. That way we'll just clear the air. Hey, there's the child molester. Come on in here, N2FTV. You sounded like a hybrid. You almost sounded like you were the old rah 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 and the Sylvester the Cat in that last transmission. Which one are you going to be today, McGrizzin? You going to be the gravelly voice guy that calls everybody motherfucker and cocksucker? Or are you going to be the nice old Armenian Sylvester the Cat that wants to recover his reputation on the ham radio? Which one is it going to be today there in 2FUV?
RSY, no problem. He's an old, decrepit man.
Where'd you go, Mike? Hey, McGrizzin, N2FTV, where'd you go? I want to hear a little more out of you there, Mike. I haven't quite heard you regain your reputation like you said you were going to do. Are you going to work on that today?
Look at those skinny arms, that big fat thing.
Where'd you go there, Mike McGrizzin, at 3023 Panorama?
Where'd you go?
Oh, my, come on. Hey, you know, you're kind of teeter-tottering back and forth. Are you going to use a gravelly voice, or are you going to use your voice? Because I need to know which one I'm talking to.
Quite a bunch of liberals on here.
It sounds like N2FUV has got his Christron. Is Clystron all loaded up? I think N2FUV is in for an afternoon of disappointment. Come on in here, Mikey. Come on in here and get you a slice of the pie, Mikey. I know you're just clamping at the bit, and I'm here to serve. That's right. Pack of Newports, a gold tooth, and some dry depends. You're ready to hit the road there, Mike. Come on in here, buddy.
Oh, my
gosh. Does he really have all that garbly shit in the background? Mike, you need to fine-tune your Clystron. It's sort of... in the background. Mike, you need to clear your voice up. I thought you were an engineer at Panasonic. What's up with that, Mike? What's up with that? You were an engineer at Panasonic, Mike. That audio does not sound like an engineer's audio, Mike. I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but that Clystron sounds like it's about to come vibrate the screws out of the cabinet.
Carol worked on it.
Oh, is that what it is? It's a Carol Madeira mod that he has in his Clystron. I understand now. Carol Madeira did the mod on Mikey's Clystron. That's the reason why he sounds like he's got a dryer with a bunch of chains and metal material there in the background running in a dryer. Mike, dude, if you're going to claim to be an engineer from Panasonic, if you're going to claim to be a gunsmith, if you're going to claim to be a owner of all the radio towers in the Nashville, Mountsville area, if you're going to claim that you're not a pedophile, you need to really get in there and clean up your audio, because Jesus Christ, Mike, it sounds like a cat in a dryer.
Hey, Whistler, I have a lollipop for you here, Whistler. Time will tell, Whistler. Payback, you know, payback, Whistler.
Oh, Mike, you sound so bad. Dude, I'm not trying to be harsh with you, dude, but your audio is probably on a scale of 1 to 10, Mike. You're probably down on a negative 1 or a negative 2 on audio. Jesus Christ, Mike. If you're going to come in here and quirm and make your point, at least make it clean and clear so other people can understand you. It's not like when you're doing skid mark and you can just go, rah, 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 cocksucker. It ain't like that, Mike. You're supposed to be talking in your real voice right now.
Yeah.
That's the morning, getting ready to quirm.